then come on across to me.
Tonight on The Experience, we're going to talk about your Worcester Railers Hockey Club unveiling of the new mascot. You get to be involved in what that mascot's name is going to be. We're going to tell you all about that coming up. We're also going to talk about Worcester and a parking, maybe get into a few other things as well as we look at some of the latest Research Bureau reports on the city of Worcester. But we begin with the achievement gap and the battle to make sure that our young people don't lose a step during these summer months. Chris, thank you for being here. Raquel, thank you for being here. Chris, before I have you get into what the achievement gap is and tell us a little bit about it, give us an overview of it, tell us about the organization that you're with, the funding that you are putting forward to battle this to make sure that Worcester students don't lose something during the summer.
Sure, Hank. So I'm the Vice President for Program at the Greater Worcester Community Foundation. The Community Foundation is an organization that really exists to improve the quality of life for everybody in Greater Worcester. Began about 40 years ago when a group of citizens came together and created a series of funds that would pay for community improvements, programs, the art museum, culture, environmental improvements through their lifetimes and afterwards through bequests. Over time, we've assembled a corpus of about $145 million that's our endowment, and the interest off that is how we fund the grants that we make every year.
Fantastic. Now, some of that money this year going to this battle against, and for several years actually, going to this battle against the achievement gap. I'm going to hold this up because this is a scary stat. Well, you tell us a little bit about the achievement gap, but this shows where there are some low-income students and just how far behind they fall, and that is ground that really becomes impossible to make up.
That's correct. And if you look at the drawing that's in your hand, we talk a lot about the achievement gap, and I think everybody hears it, and that's how low-income students and students of color end up way, way behind, sometimes irretrievably so, by the time they graduate from high school. It really starts much younger than that. And a big driver of that is summer learning loss, is that kids do okay. They work hard, their teachers work hard during the school year. Now, if you look at that picture that you gave, you see those two lines are parallel during the school year. And during the summertime, middle-class kids go up, poor kids go down. And that's where, and the gap gets wider and wider until you see how big it is by the time kids reach fifth grade.
And a lot of this, and Raquel, I guess this is where the city comes into. So a lot of this happens in the summer. Kids leave school, and they leave some of that structure. They leave behind breakfast, lunch, dinner. Maybe they're waking up, they're hungry. They don't even get one good meal during the day. But they also lose that access to work, to that structured class time, and what's happening this summer so that they don't lose some of that?
So one of the programs the city's been working on for the last 2 years is Recreation Worcester. The Recreation Worcester program, as of right now, is full year. We piloted last year being after school, and we run 8 weeks during the summer. The program runs from 9 to 5:30 in 10 park locations across the city. During that time, kids can, between the ages of 7 and 13, access our program. It's free of cost. We offer lunch. We also offer dinner. And we offer this opportunity to participate in this curriculum developed by the Worcester Education Collaborative.
Well, let's talk a little bit about that. So the kids are coming. They're getting fed. They're having a good time. And it turns out that they're learning something too. Maybe that's not put like right in their face. Maybe that's not as overt. That's kind of just woven into the tapestry of this program.
It's an outdoor learning curriculum, and through the partnership with the Greater Worcester Community Foundation, we were able to have literacy coaches come in and actually engage the curriculum and pull out literacy pieces and help our staff team really be able to engage the kids in literacy while outside, while in recreation, and with their friends in their neighborhoods.
So it's been
a fabulous.
And Chris, that's really by design, of course, that the kids are able to learn this, but that they might, you know, they may be going for a number of different things, but they probably aren't getting up and going, woohoo, I'm going to school
that
today.
I
said earlier, this has been going on for a few years now. What's the input? What are we finding out? Are we seeing that we aren't having this achievement gap, or is it narrowing, or are we keeping it at bay at least?
We're fighting the fight and we're winning some important battles. The program, in addition to the city's program that Raquel talked about, we just started funding a funding partnership with United Way a couple of years ago to bring to scale a program that was united, that was invented by a consortium of United Ways, Boston, Worcester, Springfield, about 10 years ago, where they developed these literacy coaches, embedded them in summer camp programs like at the Boys and Girls Club, like at the YMCA, and worked with those coaches, worked with the kids, worked with the staff. There were curriculum which kind of bootlegged the learning into the fun activities. And what they found is that in 75% of the cases, and this has held up over the last 7 or 8 years we've been taking data, 75% of those kids either maintain or gain ground over the summer.
Wow.
And another 20%, they lose a little, but not what you would expect. Mm-hmm. And so it's really 95% are significantly better off than they would otherwise be.
Boy, that's fantastic. One of the wonderful things about this program as well is that there's a number of partners, mm-hmm. number of people working with the city. Mm-hmm. And I don't know who maybe wants to jump in if you want to just give them a plug or a little bit of the fact that there are some others. And certainly all of this is going through the city manager's office
yes,
as well?
This is the city manager's baby. I think one of the things that we discussed is that I've had the wonderful opportunity to partner with so many wonderful, if we're talking about the Greater Worcester or we're talking about Worcester Education Collaborative or the Worcester Public Schools, it's been green lights for me every step of the way. Mm-hmm. Every time a partnership comes in, the city manager is absolutely supportive, which for me, as I've been doing this work for about 15 years, this is the most amazing growth that I've ever experienced in being able to really do something amazing as a city.
Well, I got to tell you, too, I'm thinking that this summer especially, we've only got about 1 minute, so Chris, I'll kind of give you the last word to make sure that mm-hmm. we can wrap it up here. But this is a hot summer, yeah. and there seems to be a lot of unrest out there as well. It just seems so vitally important that young people have a place to go.
It is, and the partnership is really pretty incredible. As Raquel mentioned, so we have the Worcester Public Schools, we have the United Way, we have the Greater Worcester Community Foundation, we have the City Manager's Office, and we have the Worcester Education Collaborative. We've been working together since last summer to make this summer happen. And now we're reaching about 900 kids with pretty high quality curriculum and high quality learning. And that's really, really getting us someplace. And I got to give a lot of credit to the city manager at Augustus and to what the city has done, because I've been in the nonprofit business and social services for over 30 years. And I've never seen anybody move as fast as the city has moved. It went from idea to a thing on the ground in 6 months. And then they improve it, yeah. and they're making it better, and they're just not stopping.
Spoken like the person who had to, reacted to like the person who had to make it happen in 4 months there. By the way, thank you both for coming in.
Thank you.
And telling us about this very, very important program. And of course, everybody, all the information up there on the screen for you. Check out those websites, get involved if you wish. Coming up, we're going to talk about some of the important work that the Research Bureau is doing in their latest reports. And that's going to be happening right here on the Hank Stoltz Experience.
Welcome to We Hear You, our public service announcement. Today I'd like to focus on some summer events to beat the heat. Our community is filled